Good morning, students. How are you all? Fine? Yes, I am also fine. As we are taking lot of precaution and we have to take precaution for our good health. Okay? So, we have to always follow the instruction by your parents. As if they are saying don't go outside, then don't go outside. You have to stay home for your safety. Today we are going to start our geography 4th lesson, weather and climate. All of you know what is the weather and climate. Always the climate is different for the different season, right? And sometimes the weather is hot, cool, right? So about the details of this weather, what is the difference in weather, what is the climate, all this information, detailed information we are going to study in this our fourth lesson, that is the weather and climate. In that what we are going to study, first topic is weather, then about the climate, then elements of weather, which are the elements of weather. These are the temperature, air pressure, winds, moisture and precipitations. Okay, depend on this all, these are the elements of the weather. Now we start our lesson, page number 19. Can you tell? The weather condition of few places in India are as follows on 10 June. Use the table to answer the question. See, there is a question, table is given which showing the serial number, place, state, time and weather. That means at the Kochi. In which state it is? Kerala. And at the time of 12:30 pm, the weather is cloudy. Second is Bhopal, it is in MP state. At the 12:30 pm, it is weather is hot and sunny. And third is the Mysore in Uttarakhand. At the time of 12:30 pm, the cold weather is cold weather, mild sun. See, we can notice that for all these three states, three places, the time is same, but at the same time the weather is different. Therefore, it is happen. What is the reason behind? The weather is different at the different places, but time is the same. Now, we have to learn and study about this. Why this happened? See, there is some questions given. In which place will the clothes on clothesline dry quickly? Then can you tell me in which place will the clothes on clothesline dry quickly? Of course, where is the hot and sunny region. In that place, there is the clothes are dry quickly because of the hot temperature absorb the water vapor from the clothes and it will come quickly dry. Okay, like there is a question answer here, explanation is given. So see that the weather conditions at each of the place given above are different on 10 June. Kochi has cloudy weather, it means there is a little sunlight. The rainy season has started and moisture in air will be high. Hence, it will take a long time for clothes to dry. You may have observed similar situation at your place during the rainy season. See, there is in Kochi what given the weather is a cloudy. Cloudy means there is a little bit only sunlight, rainy season is started, moisture is more at that time. So it will take the long time to dry your clothes, as we always observe in rainy season also. When there is a cloudy nature, weather, rainy is going on, that time our clothes are wetted and they are not going to dry quickly. It takes the long time. Have you observed this? I think many times we observe that when we are going to wear that clothes, they are the wetted only. Next, at the place Bhopal, there is a hot sun, the water in wet clothes get converted into vapor quickly and the clothes will dry within a short time. Because of the hot weather, that hot vapors, that water converted into the water vapors quickly and so that the clothes are getting dry quickly. Then Mysore is located to the north of the Tropic of Cancer. Where it is located? Tropic of Cancer, that is at the pole. Hence, it receives less solar heat. The air there is a cool too due to its location on mountain. Clothes take longer to dry here because of medium heat and cool air. See where it is in mountain place, and as we know, there is a at the air is going to cool at the higher places, right? So there is a it also take the longer time to dry the clothes because of the medium heat and cold air. Factors like heat, moisture, and wind influence the time taken by the clothes to dry. However, this condition keep on changing. We always experience a changes. See, wind factors are depend. That is the heat, moisture, and wind. Wind also is very important. If there is no wind, then if there is a hot temperature, that is okay. That all clothes can be dry quickly. But if there is a not a hot temperature and no dry, then can be dry quickly? No. Can you tell which of the following statements are applicable to the condition that you have experienced today or yesterday at the place where you live? See, there is some questions given. Not question, there is some statements are given. And you have to just observe. Is this with you observe yesterday or today? See that it was a cold in the morning. Now it is cold? No. In the afternoon, it became sultry. Sultry means hot and humid. Have you observed that at the afternoon time, our weather is hot and humid? That just think about that. Is you observe or not? And still if you are not observed, then observe today what is the weather in the morning, in afternoon, and in the evening time. Heat rained suddenly in the afternoon. Cool breeze was blowing at dawn. Cool breeze was blowing. That means early in the morning, before the sunrise, that is at the dawn time. Have you observed the cool breezes? That time is always cool breezes most of the time, right? Weather. We all always experience atmospheric conditions prevailing at a place and at a given time. We often talk about it, but this condition are short-lived. This is what we call weather. What is the weather? See, many times we saw that there is for the few times the weather is different. For the other next time or period, the weather is different. That means the weather is very, or this changes is for the very short time, for the short period. And this is called only weather. The weather is not for the long time. It remains only for the short period or short time. For example, we say weather is hot, cool, dry, and sultry. See, the weather is always changes. Sometimes we feel very hot, sometimes we feel cool. Right? Next, page number 20. Can you tell, since childhood, you have experienced summer, rainy season, and winters? On the basis of your experience, answer the following questions. See, on the basis of our experience, now you have to give the answer. In which months do summer, the rainy season, and winter occurs in a year from January to December? That we already know. The in which season, how many seasons are there? That is the summer season, rainy season, winter season. And which season in which month it occurs? Right? That you, I think all of you know now this very well. Right? So you can give this answer. Which special clothes do we use if it is raining? If it is raining, then which clothes we use? That is the raincoats. Right? These clothes we use. When do we use woolen clothes? When do we use woolen clothes? In the winter season. In which season do we mainly use thin cotton clothes? In summer season, right? In summer season, we use the cotton clothes. Explanation about the climate. Now, I hope you understood what is the weather. Weather, it is for the storm. That is the changes in the climate, in the weather, what happened. It is for only the short period. That is called the weather. Now, climate. What is the climate? You must have noticed that each season lasts for a particular period and each season occurs at particular time of the year. The scientists observe the weather in a region for many years. With help of such studies, they define the weather conditions. See, as we know, there is a particular seasons are there and their time is also the period is also there. As for the example, for the summer season, there are the 4 months for the summer season. For the rainy months, rainy season, there are also 4 months. And as they all the decided. The average weather condition of place observed over a long period of time is climate of that region. Climate is generally expressed as cool and dry, or hot and humid, or hot and dry, etc. See, the average weather condition, that means this weather, average weather condition is remained for the long period or long time, that is called the climate. Okay, and climate, how we can say the climate? There is a dry or hot, and cool and dry, and hot and humid. In this three forms, we can say the climate. The weather changes quite often due to changes in temperature, winds and humidity, etc. We always experience these changes, or sum total of all these elements define weather. This affects our day-to-day activities and lifestyle. Elements of weather are taken into consideration while describing the climate. See, weather changes is depend on the temperature, wind and humidity. On this weather is depend, and because of the weather average, that climate is depend. But climate is for the long period, weather is for the short period. Because of the temperature, humidity, air, winds, and as they changes, the weather is changes. Now, the weather, elements of weather. Which are the elements of weather? We already see here the temperature, air pressure, winds, moisture, and precipitations are the elements of weather. But what is that? First one is temperature. The earth's surface gets heat from the sun. As a result, the surface gets heated up. The air close to the surface start becoming hot, and later, one by one, different layers of air at higher elevation receive heat. Therefore, as we move upward from the sea level, the temperature of air decreases. The temperature also goes on decreasing from equator towards both the pole. See, the temperature, as the earth absorbs the heat, and because of the earth, when the earth absorbs heat, that means it eliminates the heat also, right? Whenever we are walking in the summer season or there is a hot place, and if you are not wearing your foot, sandals and all that thing, then what will happen? You feeling the hot to the leg, right? And whatever the air is surrounding to the surface of the earth, that also getting the heated because of the earth is eliminate the that heat, right? So air surrounding to the surface of the earth is also getting the heat hot, and this air passes the heat transfer to the other layer of the surface or the air. So other air is also getting the hot. Then whenever there is a hot season, see, always be feeling the hot air also. We are not in the hot season, we are not never feeling the cold weather, cold air, right? Because of the hot surface, the air also getting the hot. But as we go to the up level of the sea level, that is the temperature is going to decrease. At the pole of the earth, there also temperature is decreases. Then air pressure. Air has a weight, as a result it creates pressure. It is called air pressure. The lowermost layer of air gets subjected to the pressure of the upper layer. Hence, the density of lower layers of air increases. There is a greater air pressure near the surface of the earth, and it decreases with increasing height. This is vertical air pressure. These changes also occur in horizontal manner. This gives rise to wind. See, what is the air pressure? Air also has the weight. See, if we take the balloon and we when we blow that balloon, then what will happen? The air is pass into that balloon, and balloon is going to blow like this, right? It's like the ball. We can see the shape. But that means it shows the some weight is there, and this weight is called the air pressure. The weight of the air is called air pressure. That means weight is create the pressure. The lowermost layer of air gets subjected to the pressure of the upper layer. See, at the surface of the earth, the pressure is more. And as we go upside or to the up level, then the pressure is also decreases. Winds. Air starts moving from high pressure towards the low pressure area in horizontal direction. See, once air also started moving from high pressure to low pressure region. There is a where is a high pressure region from that from them there that it passes to the low pressure region. This moving air is called wind. What is the wind? The moving air. What is the see when always we are saying wind is coming, wind is very cool and like that. That means the moving air is called the wind. Wind blows from high to low pressure areas and its speeds depend on the amount of difference in a air pressure. Wind is depend the amount of air pressure. If the air pressure is high, it is also wind pressure is more. And it always blows from high pressure to low pressure region. Moisture. Next is about the moisture. Moisture, we already know the amount of water vapor in the air. That is called the moisture. But here is given. The atmosphere contains vapor. The air that has greater amount of vapor is called humid air. The humidity in the atmosphere is called moisture. The proportion of moisture in atmosphere depends on temperature. Air with higher temperature holds greater amount of moisture. See, air is the atmosphere contains the vapor. Okay, the air contains the water vapor, and it is called the air contains absorb the vapor is called moisture, and the humidity, that is the moisture in the air, is called the humidity. And the proportion of moisture is increases as the temperature is increases. That means if the temperature is more, then moisture absorb. The air also absorb the moisture in high level. Then next is the precipitation. Vapor in the atmosphere condenses into water droplets or snow particles. Their showering on the earth is called precipitation. Rainfall, snowfall, hailstorm, etc. are forms of precipitation. So, what is the precipitation? The vapor in the atmosphere. We know the vapor in the atmosphere. The air absorbs this water vapor, and this water vapor is condenses in the form of droplets or snow. This process is called the precipitation. Okay, and in which form? That is the rainfall, snowfall. And hailstorm. Weather is described on the basis of conditions prevailing at the given time, while climate is described on the basis of condition prevailing over a longer period of time. See here given, as the weather is described as prevailing at the given time. That means for the short period of time. But the climate is described the prevailing for the long period of time. Short and long period. Okay, that is the difference. Weather is changing frequently and we can experience the changes easily. Changes in the climate take place over a long period of time. These are not perceived easily. Latitudinal position. Height above sea level, nearness to ocean, oceanic currents, etc. are the factors that influence the climate. Which factors are influence the climate? That is the latitudinal position, height above the sea level, nearness to the ocean, oceanic currents, etc. That means if you are near by the oceanic coastal area, the climate is different. See, all these things are effect on the climate. Besides this, mountain ranges, types of land, local winds are other factors that influence the climate of region. That means it depends on the of your areas, where in which area you are there, the climate is according to that. See in the next page number 21. In the next chapter we shall see more information about temperature. In this lesson we just learn about the short about the temperature, that is the temperature is high at the surface of the earth, right? And about the detailed study we are going to study in our next lesson. Always remember, the weather at a place keeps changing frequently, but the climate does not change that often. The climate is different at different locations within our country, India. It is cool at some places, hot at some other places. It is not necessary that climate is same for all the places. Okay. Even in India also, in some places the climate is hot, in some places it is the cool. Weather is continuously changes, but climate is not continuously changes. It takes a long period. I hope you understood what is the weather and climate, what is the difference between the weather and climate. So study well at home.